three friends decided to race to a flag. Let's see who wins the race. So the guy in the center won the race. Do you think that he had some edge over the other two? Well, this friend who was on his right, that is the one in the yellow tracksuit, was certain that there was something wrong. He was a much faster runner than the guy in the center, and so he decided to do something to prove that the distance he ran, that is this green line, was actually less than the distance he had to run, which is the yellow line. So what does he do? He takes the help of maths and he proves this using maths. Let's see what he does. So this starting line is AB. Let's say the finishing point, which is the finishing flag, let's call this point as F. The friend who was in the center, let's call him C. And the one who was on the right side, let's call him R. So what we know is that the one who was in the center was actually directly in front of the flag, or I can say he was perpendicularly to the line. He was, this line FC is perpendicular to AB. He was directly in front of the flag. Whereas R, now R and C, these two points lie on this line AB. So what we know is that FC is perpendicular to AB and R is a point that lies on this line AB. They all started from the same starting line. What do you want to prove? This friend wanted to prove that this green line, that is FC, was less than FR. That is, the distance that his friend had to run, who won the race, was actually less than the distance he had to run till the flag. So let us see how he proves this. So he wants to prove FC is less than FR. What do we know? We know that in this triangle, angle FCR is 90 degrees. Let's write that down. Angle FCR is 90 degrees since FC is perpendicular to AB. Now let's call this angle as angle 1. And say, call this as angle 2. If this is 90 degrees, I know sum of angles in a triangle is 180 degrees. So I can say that 90 degrees plus angle 1 plus angle 2. In this triangle, sum of 90, 1 and 2 should be 180 degrees. So I can say that angle 1 plus angle 2 would be 90 degrees. Since sum of 1 and 2 is 90 degrees, angle 1 would be less than 90 degrees. If you add something to 1, then it is giving 90 degrees. So 1 is clearly less than 90 degrees. So angle FCR is 90 and angle 1 is less than 90 degrees. Now what can I say? We know that FCR is equal to 90 degrees and angle 1 is less than 90. Since 90 is equal to same as writing FCR, I can say that angle 1 is less than angle FCR. I can say that angle 1 is actually less than angle FCR. So in this triangle, I have one angle, which is angle 1, less than the other angle, which is angle FCR. Since this is the smaller angle, the side opposite to it, which is FC, should be smaller. Hence, I can say that FC is less than FR. FR is the side opposite to 90 degrees. FC is the side which is opposite to angle 1. Smaller angle, smaller side, greater angle, greater side. So I can say FC was less than FR. He was correct. The guy in the center actually had an edge over the other two. His distance was way less than the other two. Now let us see. If you have a line L and say I have a point, let me draw this point and I call this point as P. Now let's draw different lines from this point to this line L. So if I draw different lines from this point to this line L, what you would see is that the one that is the shortest is actually the perpendicular line. So this line, which is the shortest, let's call it PD, this line is the shortest and is perpendicular to the line L. So for all line segments which you can draw from a point P to a line L, the one that is shortest is the one that is perpendicular to it. Remember this. So we have seen that distance between two points is defined by the straight line or the shortest line. So rather than any curved line, I say that this line AB, which is the straight line AB, the red line, is the shortest one, which is from A to B. This straight line that joins these two points is the shortest one, and hence that is the distance between these two points. Now what about distance between a point and a line? Again, now if I draw any line from this point to this line L, the one that is shortest would be the distance, and the one that is shortest is actually the line that is perpendicular to this. So whenever we talk about distance of a point to a line, we always talk about perpendicular distance.